Ever felt a bit lost when it comes to cars? You're not alone. But fear not, for today, I'm here to unravel the mystery and simplify everything you may find underneath your hood. So whether you're a beginner under the hood, eager to dive into the intricacies of engines, or simply want to keep up when your friends start geeking out over their engine bays, this video is your 101 guide to understanding it all. What's going on, my good people? Mike Hidalgo here. Thank you for joining me on another Cars Explained, a quick mini series where we talk about the absolute basics of your vehicle at home. This is for you new DIYers, first time drivers, first time vehicle owners, or just those of you that want to learn a little bit more about your car at home. Everything we're going to be covering in this series is information that you can find in your owner's manual. And if it's not something you have handy, be sure to hop online and do a quick search. Usually you can find them online. If you have any questions about the cars that we're going to be looking at today, be sure to leave some comments in the comment section below. Behind me, we're going to be showing a naturally aspirated vehicle. We have a supercharged vehicle, a turbocharged vehicle, and even a supercharged and turbocharged vehicle. A little bit of every flavor, showing you how they're all just a little bit different, but yet still very similar, so you can follow along with your car at home. So with that, let's go ahead and see what's under the hood. So starting with our naturally aspirated vehicle, the first thing you want to look for are your reservoirs. Now, this car being a little bit older has a power steering system that's hydraulically assisted, meaning we're going to have a reservoir for hydraulic fluid. If your car is a bit newer, you more than likely have electric assisted steering, so you're not going to have one of these reservoirs. So don't panic if you don't find it. Again, always refer to your owner's manual if you're not sure. Like any reservoir, they're going to be labeled with what they are supplying fluid for and what kind of fluid they should take. Power steering is always going to have a small steering wheel symbol on it, or it will say steering fluid, as well as the type of fluid they take. You can always open them up, check the level. They typically have a dipstick if it's a black canister like this that doesn't have a max or low symbol on the side, and see what your fluid is at, top off or flush as needed. Next under the hood is going to be your brake fluid. You're always going to have a brake fluid reservoir, typically located on the same side as your brake pedal. On this BMW, it happens to hide underneath the cowl, so you can pop your covers off if you have covers hiding them and check the fluid level. This is something that should be replaced every year or two, depending on the kind of driving you do. And if you want to learn how to flush your own brake fluid at home, be sure to check one of the links in the description below where we show you how to do that by yourself. Moving on, we're going to have a cooling system, and that cooling system is going to need an expansion tank for the coolant. Those are typically located on the passenger side, at least on BMWs. These can come in all shapes and flavors. This one happens to be a black expansion tank, meaning there is no high or low mark on the side of it, showing you the coolant level. These you're going to have to check by removing the cap. There's a little bobber inside of them that give you the fluid level. And typically your containers are going to be labeled, showing you what the min level is and what the max is. Key thing to take away on any vehicle that you want to check the cooling system for, always do it when the vehicle is cold. Never do it when it's hot. You risk injury to yourself and you risk damaging the vehicle. Along with that, you're going to want to probably learn how to top off your windshield washer fluid. I know I get the light on, especially during the winter, and it's the most annoying thing ever. Those can be found under the hood as well. In this case, you're going to be labeled with a windshield washer logo, showing a little bit of fluid squirting up. Don't mix those up with your coolant, especially if they happen to be the same color. Another thing you may not be seeing here is your battery. Your battery may be located in the engine bay on your vehicle. In this case, this one's located in the trunk. If yours is in the trunk and your vehicle is dead, sometimes you can't jump it from there without taking the whole car apart. Those type of cars like this one will have a jump post up front. That's always going to be labeled with a red cover or a red positive symbol. And usually with that is going to be a negative ground to attach your other terminal to. In this case, this one's located by the expansion tank. If you can't find a negative ground like this, use a ground like a chassis ground, something similar to the strut bar or strut brace hardware. That'll help you get your car jump started. And along with that, you're going to want to know where to top off your engine oil from. In this case, it's going to be labeled with a little oil can, and oftentimes this will indicate what type of oil to put in and what weight of oil to put in as well. If you're unsure of how much oil to put into your vehicle, be sure to check your owner's manual, as it will tell you all that information in there. Familiarize yourself with it, learn how to open the cap, especially if you need to do a roadside top off. Along with the engine, you always have an engine filter. These can be found either up top, like on this model, or down below, sometimes in front of the engine. Be sure to familiarize yourself with that as well. And you've heard me say it before, that is something you can find on your owner's manual. At the front side of the engine, meaning the side that your crank pulley is on or your alternator is on, you're going to have your belts. These can be hard to see depending on the type of car you have. On this BMW, they're located beneath these hoses here. So if you have a squeaky belt or you have a mechanic telling you that you need a new water pump or a new belt, take a look for yourself, grab a flashlight, you should be able to find it. If you can't find the belt system, try to find the alternator, which on every car is going to look about the same. It's a caged cylinder. Think of a hamster wheel. On this car, it's located right up top. If you can find that, you can find your belts. And lastly, while you're poking in there, take a look at the front half of your vehicle. You're going to find your radiator support, your radiator, and your cooling fans. In this case, this car is equipped with an electrical fan. Some vehicles have a mechanical fan, so just something to keep in mind and be wary of when you're looking underneath the hood. And just to show you how the basics of what's under the hood remains the same, let's head over to a different vehicle and show you the same examples. Over here in Supercharged land, my good people, you can see the basics immediately remain the same. The locations of things change like they will on every vehicle, but the idea is all there. On this side, you have your coolant expansion tank. You can see this one happens to be a clear housing unit, giving you a max and min line, making it super easy to check without having to open the system. Similarly to that, on the driver's side of the vehicle up by the firewall, we can find the brake fluid reservoir, super important to be able to check, labeled a little bit different, but still giving you the right information that you need. And just like our naturally aspirated vehicle, this supercharged vehicle also has an air filter or air box, this one having an aftermarket system that feeds air into the engine. Unlike the BMW, however, this one doesn't really have a large beauty cover hiding everything. You can see your ignition coils are exposed, spark plugs being underneath them, making it really easy to tell how many cylinders this vehicle has. Just simply by looking at it, you can tell this is a 6-cylinder vehicle. If rears are covered and you're unsure how many cylinders your vehicle has, sometimes they're labeled on the actual body cladding of the car. You can check your owner's manual, or if you have an exposed engine like this, you can count how many ignition coils you have. Unlike the BMW, that's a bit hidden. If you want to get a little nerdy, you can count how many runners you have on the intake manifold and tell that way. With a supercharged vehicle, you have air being compressed by impellers, belt driven by the front belt system of the vehicle. This Audi, you can pull off the small beauty cover and see that supercharger exposed right there. Like anything else, this has its own oil system and belt system that needs to be serviced regularly. And just to get even more basic and show you how similar cars truly can be, let's take a look at a turbocharged example. All right, my good people, I get it. You don't have an NA vehicle. You don't have a supercharged vehicle. You have a turbocharged vehicle. Well, guess what, my good people? The things remain the same. Just starting over here by the driver's side of the car, we have our windshield washer reservoir. Here's a little logo on that, making it super easy to find, followed by our air box or air filter, which this car is equipped with an aftermarket unit as well, but doing the same function nonetheless. Now, this car being turbocharged, what sets this apart from the supercharged or naturally aspirated engine is that it has a small turbine, and a small turbine with two halves that take the exhaust gas, force it back into the engine, giving you more power and more performance in a very basic and simple manner. Along with that, you're going to have your beauty cover, which again can change depending on the vehicle. This one being a simple one to work on, you can simply lift it off and inspect what's underneath it. As you can see, there is no hardware holding this one down. So if you don't see any hardware, then more than likely they just pop off. That's going to expose your ignition coils, just like we saw on the Audi, and it can show you how many cylinders you have. If you're trying to get underneath the beauty cover, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 with the spark plugs living underneath. This vehicle being direct injected, the injectors are going to be a little bit more hidden versus if you remove the cover on the BMW, they would be a little bit more exposed. Now, similar to the Audi we were looking at, the expansion tank on this car is also a see-through unit, allowing you to see the coolant level of the vehicle without having to open up the system. Unlike the other cars we've looked at, this car is equipped with a dipstick. So if you're looking to check your oil level, you're going to see usually a yellow or red handle. Typically, these can be labeled with a little oil symbol, just like you would have on your oil fill cap, which will allow you to check your oil level. Now, keep in mind that not every vehicle has a dipstick, especially as cars get newer. They tend to have an electronic system that allows you to check the oil level from inside the car, which is something you can learn by checking out the owner's manual. Easier to see on this car is going to be your alternator and belt system, just due to the way the engine is laid out under the hood. And with the alternator comes also your vehicle's battery. Now, on this car, it happens to be one that lives in the engine bay underneath the hood. They can be located in the engine bay, they can be located in the firewall, or oftentimes in the trunk of the vehicle. So keep that in mind if you're looking to jumpstart your vehicle. Some will have the battery easily accessible up front, some will have them buried in the trunk, and vice versa. And just to drive home how similar the basics are on all these vehicles, let's wrap it up with a much newer example that is both turbocharged and supercharged. Now, over here on our final and newest vehicle, even though we have a more complex engine, we have a turbocharged, supercharged, four-cylinder T6 from Volvo. The idea still remains the same, my good people. The basics are all here. It's just a matter of being able to find them. At this point, we started with the rudimentary BMW, showing you what some of the expansion tanks can look like, what some of the simples can look like, and with that, you should be able to find them on any car that you have. Over on the driver's side here, we have our air box slash air filter, which is going to be the same as any of the other vehicles we were seeing. Same service applies to it every 10 to 20,000 miles or 1 to 2 years. Now, as we move forward, things tend to get a little bit more hidden, and that is just due to the nature of newer vehicles changing over time. We have our jump post, which is nice and highlighted here. This car has a battery in the rear of the vehicle. We have our windshield washer fluid, which is still labeled with the same symbol that we saw all the way back in the 2008 BMW. Something that's a little bit more hidden, but those of you with an eagle eye, or those of you that have been paying attention will find, is our brake fluid. Our brake fluid is located under this cover here, which is labeled with a brake reservoir symbol. Popping that cover off will expose the reservoir, allowing you to see the level and fluid condition, just like we could on the other vehicles, just by being a bit more sleek on this newer design. Over on the passenger side, you're wondering, well, Mike, I don't see an expansion tank. And that makes two of us, my good people, because Volvo did a nice job hiding it here in the cowl, allowing you to twist this off and checking the fluid there. Now, I will say with this, they get a little bit tighter and harder to inspect. Sometimes a flashlight is going to be needed, but nonetheless, everything is still available for you to look at. Something that's well exposed on this vehicle, which we haven't mentioned too much on the other models, is your service ports for your air conditioning. As these cars get newer, the systems are starting to go away from R134A, which has been the common for the last 20 years or so. So this is something you're typically not going to want to touch, but if you were curious, they're always going to be labeled with the amount of pressure they take, and they look like two little twist-off caps, one port being bigger than the other. Something that's a little bit different on the newer vehicles versus the older BMW and Audi we looked at is the beauty covers. This one is more of an insulation cover than anything else. It's not that beautiful, sorry Volvo, but it is thick. It is a thick foam that helps reduce the engine noise that's being emitted, keeping it nice and quiet inside the cabin as well as outside the cabin. However, everything else remains the same, my good people. You have your ignition coils, which are located underneath the beauty cover, spark plugs that live underneath. This vehicle being direct injected, the injectors are also hidden underneath our intake manifold there, but the idea continues to be the same. Oil fill cap is located right in the center of the cylinder head, but no dipstick unlike the Volkswagen we were just looking at. Belt system is still here up front. You can find the hamster cage looking alternator. Supercharger is going to be driven off the backside over here, a little bit harder to see, making it a little bit harder to inspect, unlike the Audi, which was right up top. And so with that, my good people, even though this car is light years ahead of the first model we started with, the point here was to show you what's under the hood and how all the basics remain the same. Hopefully you've learned a little bit more about your own car. Don't forget to refer to your owner's manual if you have any further questions. And if you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments on what we did today, leave that in the comments section below. And if you like this Cars Explained and you want to see a few more basic videos like this, please be sure to subscribe, as we're making new ones all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you in the next one.